Hey there, how you doing, Cage? My name is Robert. In this guitar lesson, we're going to play a very classic song that's called Knights in White Satin from the British rock formation The Moody Blues. Before we start the lesson, I want to say that we do have a website, Robert Dr. Mandolin, that you can find playing charts, chords, with and out solos, anything you need to help you with the songs you're playing during these video lessons. My wife Cecilia creates all files on printable PDFs, so visit our website. And here's Joost, our movie star. Say hello to your fans, Joost. Joost has fans all over the world. He's receiving more fan mail than I do. Okay, boy. So let's look at the song. There's an intro, verse, chorus, solo, verse, chorus, and a final chorus. Let's start with the intro. Play it out for you and then explain it. Here we go. That's the intro, sounds nice, isn't it? How are we going to play that? We're starting with the E minor chord, two times, three counts. So the song is in a waltz tempo, so the counting goes 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So here we go, E minor, two times, three counts. And use a smooth way of strumming, with the beat on the first count. Next chord is a D chord, special thing. If you're watching live clips of the Moody Blues, you're just seeing Justin Hayward play a regular D chord. But on this D chord, the bass player is playing an F sharp. It's a nice combination. So you can play this both ways. Use the regular D chord, sounds correct. Or if you want the nice way, D chord, thump over the neck. It's a Jimi Hendrix trick, by the way. Thump over the neck, squeeze the string on the second position, the top string. And muffle the A string with the tip of the thump. D chord, F sharp bass. And that's with every D chord here in the song. So you can play it a regular D chord or D chord, F sharp bass. There we go. D chord, two times, three counts. One. E minor, three counts. One. Now we're getting a riff. Open E string, the top string. The ring finger on the third position, top string. Back to open E. And then we're getting D chord, F sharp bass, two times, three counts. One. E minor chord, three counts. One. So one more time, the whole intro for you. There we go. That's the intro. We're entering verse number one. Play it out for you and then explain it. There we go. First number one, we're gonna play that. We're starting with the first line, E minor chord, three counts. One. D chord, or D chord F sharp bass, whatever you prefer. One. Back to E minor, two times, three counts. One. D chord, two times, three counts. One. Line number two of the first verse, C chord, two times, three counts. One. G chord, two times, three counts. F chord, two times, three counts. E minor, three plus one count this time. And now a small riff, open E string. Ring finger E3. And back to E minor chord, three counts. So one more time, the second line of this first verse for you. Here we go, starting with the C chord. Thank you. line number 3 of the first verse, E minor, 3 counts, D chord, F sharp bass, 2 times 3 counts, E minor again, 2 times 3 counts, D chord, line number 4 of the first verse, C chord, 2 times 3 counts, G chord, 2 times 3 counts, F chord, 2 times 3 counts, E minor, 3 counts. That's verse number 1, re-entering the chorus. Play it out for you and then explain it. There we go. There's a chorus, so we're gonna play that, starting with the first line, E minor, 3 downstrums, and then we're getting an A chord, 3 times, 3 counts, plus 1. Line number 2 of this chorus, starting with a riff, open A string, ring finger, 3rd position top string. C chord, 4 times, 3 counts. Line number 3 of the chorus, E minor, 2 times, 3 counts. D chord, F sharp bass. E minor, 2 times, 3 counts. D chord, 2 times, 3 counts. E minor, 3 counts. That's the chorus. We're entering verse number 2. There's a small difference in, so I'll play it out for you and then explain it. There we go. That's verse number 2. We're gonna play that. We're starting with the first line. E minor chord, 3 counts. D chord. D chord, F sharp bass, whatever you prefer. E minor, 3 counts. We're getting a riff. Open E string. Ring finger E3. Open E again. D chord, 2 times, 3 counts. Line number 2 of the second verse. C chord, 2 times 3 counts, G chord, 2 times 3 counts, F chord, 2 times 3 counts, E minor chord, 3 plus 1 count. Small riff, open E string, ring finger E3, E minor chord, 3 counts. Line number 3 of the second verse, continue, E minor chord, 3 counts, D chord, 2 times 3 counts, E minor, 3 counts, riff, open, ring finger, E3, back to open E, D chord. Line number 4 of the second verse, C chord, 2 times 3 counts, G chord, 2 times 3 counts, F chord, 2 times 3 counts, E minor, 3 counts. That's verse number 2, re-entering the chorus again. Small difference in it, so I'll play it out for you and then explain it. There we go. That's the chord. So we're going to play that. We're starting the first line, E minor, 3 down strums. A chord, 3 times, 3 counts, plus 1. Here we go. Line number 2 of this chorus, open A string, ring finger on E3. C chord, 4 times, 3 counts. Line number 3 of this chorus, E minor, 2 times, 3 counts. D chord. Back to E minor. D chord again. E minor, 1 down strum. And then we're getting a step down riff. The middle finger on D2 is already there. The next finger, A2 is already there. Ring finger, third position E string. 1 down strum on the E minor chord. So one more time, line number 3 of this chorus. Starting with E minor, here we go. As a chorus, we're entering the solo part. Play it out for you and then explain it. Here we go. That's the rhythm part of the solo, the flute solo. Very nice. I'm gonna play that. The first part of the solo part is played in a very low volume because of the flute. It can't beat the noise of the guitars. So, first line of the solo part, E minor, 2 times, 3 counts. There we go. D chord. D chord F sharp bass, but we prefer. C chord, 2 times 3 counts. B7 chord, 2 times 3 counts. Line number 2 of this solo part. E minor again, 2 times 3 counts. D chord. C chord. B7 chord, 2 times 3 counts. Line number 3 of the solo part, E minor, 2 times 3 counts, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, C chord, G bass, that's a normal C chord plus the ring finger on the third position of the top string. Visit our website, there you can find all the chords you need to play this song. So here we go, C chord, G bass, 2 times 3 counts, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, back to E minor, 2 times 3 counts, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, C chord G bass, again, 2 times C counts. Line number 4 on the solo part, A suspended 2, it's a normal A chord without the ring finger. A suspended 2, 2 times C counts. B7 chord, 2 times 3 counts. A minor chord this time. B7 chord again, 2 times 3 counts. And now we're working up to an end of the solo part, so we're starting to hit the volume pedal. So we're getting E minor now, 2 times 3 counts, and we're swelling on. D chord, F sharp bass. C chord, G bass. Line number 5 of the solo part, E minor, 2 times 3 counts. D chord, E minor. minor, 2 times he counts. D chord, 2 times he counts. E minor, 1 downstroke. And 2 counts rest. That's the rhythm part of the solo. We entering verse number 3. Play it out for you and then explain it. There we go. Number 3, we're gonna play that, starting the first line, E minor, 3 counts. D chord, D chord, F sharp, bass. E minor again, 2 times, 3 counts. D chord again, 2 times, 3 counts. Line number 2 of the third verse, C chord, 2 times, 3 counts. G chord, F chord, 2 times 3 counts. E minor, 3 plus 1 count. Riffje, open E. E3. E minor, 3 counts. Line number 3 of the third verse. E minor, 3 counts. D chord. E minor, 2 times 3 counts. D chord again. Line number 4 of the third verse. C chord, 2 times 4 counts. 3 counts, excuse me. G chord. F chord, 2 times 3 counts. E minor chord, 3 counts. Re-entering the chorus. Play out and then explain it. Here we go. That's the chord, so we're gonna play that. Starting first line, E minor, 3 downstrums. A chord, 3 times, 3 counts, plus 1. Line number 2 of this chorus, open A string, ring finger, E3. C chord, 4 times, 3 counts. Line number 3 of the chorus, E minor, 2 times, 3 counts. D chord, E minor, 2 times, 3 counts. D chord again, 2 times, 3 counts. And now we're getting E minor, 3 times, 3 counts, plus 1. And we're going to play that in this way. One more time, and then one extra downstroke. So one more time, line number 3 of this chorus, starting with E minor, here we go. Bring the final chorus, play out for you and then explain it. There we go. Final chord. So we're gonna play that, starting with the first line, starting with the start-up riff, open E string, ring finger, third position E string. And then A chord, three times, three counts, plus one. Line number two of the final chorus, open A string, ring finger E3, C chord, four times, three counts. Line number three of this final chorus, E minor, two times, three counts. D chord, E minor again, D chord. Now we're getting E minor again, one down strum, and we're creating an ending riff to end the song. So pick D2, the middle finger is already there, A2, index finger is already there, ring finger E3, open A string, and then one down strum on the E minor chord. So one more time. The final line of this final chorus for you, starting with E minor, here we go. Beautiful song, to play on an acoustic guitar. That's the whole song, Nights in White Satin Explained. It's more an idea of mine to create the song, so I mixed chords and bass riffs together to get a kind of a dynamic in the song instead of just pumping up and down playing chords. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. I did, and I hope to see you all next time. Visit our website, Robert Dr. Mandolin. Take care, ciao, tschüss, arrivederci, buenas noches, dos vidania, how do, goodbye, and Reformjoost. Woofie.